a dingo steal your remote? We're getting ready for Australia Day with some fair dinkum, true blue, bloody unreal Australian comedy legends. We'll all be rooted. Here's your hosts, Aunty Donna.
Hello, I'm Zach, I'm Mark, I'm Broden, and we're Aunty Donna. Us three boys have got some very exciting stuff coming up tonight. You can say that again, Broden. Oh, I will. Other two boys who are standing next to me, we got skits, bits, interrupting, and plenty of goofs. Zach, maybe from you, we've got some great guests and we might even do a little bit of this. Dances. Great dancing, Mark. Where did you learn that? Oh, I learned that at the old Five and Dime. Gee whiz, Mark. You and your Five and Dimes. Boys, enough flim-flamming about, so we got a monologue to do. Oh, I forgot all about the monologue, but what are we going to talk about, Broden? I don't know, what happened this week? Well, Tony Abbott's in the news again, Zach. When's the last time you read a newspaper? Yeah, you doingus. Malcolm Turnbull's our president now. Malcolm Turnbull, I wouldn't be saying his name around these parts. Winks at camera. As you know, it's Australia Day tomorrow, and I just can't wait to have a few of these mimes having a beer and good times with pals. Haha, sounds like fun, Zach. But me, I'll be having some yummy snags and a listen to the Hottest 100. Cool, man. So cool. What about you, Broden? What will you be getting up to? Beers, babes, good times with mates? Haha, whatever you juvenile little boys. I'm a real man, a big grown-up man, so I'll be having a crisp Marlboro Sauv Blanc and getting into the latest Matthew Riley novel. Oh, Broden, chill out and have some fun, why don't you? Okay, maybe I'll have a couple of beers, winks at camera. Okay, guys, I know what you're thinking. Who are these three bawdy boys gallivanting about? Well, let's introduce ourselves. Broden, did you want to start? Sure. Hi. I'm Broden, or bro to me mates. I'm a red-blooded man with me ginger locks, my little beard and rugged good looks. I love lifting weights and crushing cardboard boxes. Hi, I'm Zach. I'm the lovable goofball who enjoys wine, pita bread and iced lattes with froth. I've never had one like that before and I don't know how they did it, but it was cold froth. And I'm Mark. I'm small with a big beard. Look, my bushy beard. I will run my fingers through it now. Runs fingers through beard. Gee, I love my beard. So that's us, three boys. One, two, three. Who love having fun and having a lark. But in all seriousness, I think you tuned in expecting to see something a little bit different to what you're seeing right now. And you'd be right. Mark is wearing a silly hat. Take it off, Mark, okay? Sorry, I'll take it off, lol, times 20. We have heaps of special guests tonight. We can't wait for you to meet them. Greg Larson was going to be here, but Zach gave him the wrong night. He told him it was tomorrow night. I said I was sorry, you didn't have to bring it up. Sorry, I was just trying to fill up time. Well, now I'm embarrassed. Me, Zach, the tall one with the mustache. Look at my mustache. I will touch it now. I am touching my mustache. Anyway, that's all from us so far. Thanks for tuning in. We're going to go to an ad break now, but there'll be more from us three boys after the break. Now let's dance to some dubstep. They dance. Hello, and welcome back to About Tonight with Aunty Donna. We're Aunty Donna. Thanks for tuning in. Our first guest for tonight is a really shit sketch group. They are so shit and we hate them so much. Welcome, Aunty Donna.
Yes!
Hello! Everyone! Clapping!
Camera 3, how you going?
Broden Kelly!
Yeah, it's my banana!
Here comes Broden Kelly!
Everyone, we're over the joke now. It's okay, you can go.
Thanks, Felicia.
Thank you.
You can leave now. Hello,
Melbourne and Geelong and Apollo Bay.
Well, it's time for us to kick back and have a good old-fashioned Australia Day.
We're having an Aussie,
guys.
We're having a good old Aussie-fashioned kick about and a lark about.
Guys, I'm going to do my hair.
Oh, very good,
Brandon.
And I'll tell you what, it's the fashion police. Hello?
Yes, who's
You're
this?
Not under arrest.
Because
you look great.
This is all fun already. This is live. fuckers.
Oh, what?
This is live
television, ladies
Why
and gentlemen.
Why are they letting us do this live?
Oh, boy. Do we have a cavalcade full of things for you tonight? We're going to be doing them. We've got so many great special guests, and why don't we introduce our first special guest?
I regret rubbing gel in my hair.
I would imagine that's a regrettable sige.
Are you okay?
I don't know. I'm really nervous.
All right, that's okay. So there's nothing to be nervous about.
Here, let me rub gel on your face.
Oh, I like that.
Oh, Jesus. Now that you mention
it.
Guys, I think I'm a little bit low on gel in my hair, actually, now that you mention it.
Let me help you out there, mate. All right, cheers. Thank you.
Woo! Nothing. You want to eat live TV, guys. You want to look good for the pictures.
You can't do a show without gel.
No, you can't, boys.
All right, boys and girls. I believe there's another bit we're going to do now. I don't really know what the bit is.
You got to look good for the TV.
I think we're going to meet our first friend.
All right, let's go over to our first friend.
Tom Armstrong, the musician... musical component of Aunty Donna. He can't be here today, so we got his best friend and
our confidant.
He was in Jersey Boys.
Let's bring him on.
Jersey Boys.
Please make a welcome Joe Kosky.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Have some gel.
Thank you. So good to be here, mate.
Good to see you, Joe.
We got off onto the wrong foot last year, and
that's right. We had Joe on the show last year, and he got mad at us.
But we're going to do things right.
Grab a seat.
So Joe, grab a seat, Joe. A seat.
I'm just,
Now, Joe,
thank you for asking me to be an interviewee.
Absolute pleasure, Joe. Anyone... You know we love you, and you know we're always welcome on to About when we're doing an About Tonight show.
When we first did About Tonight in 1997, we had Joe Kosky on this show, and we got in a little bit of a fight because he believes we kicked him out of the group. But we just want to say, Joe, we're sorry about that. Also, Tom has a shift at his job at Coles tonight.
Tom still works at Coles.
And we all have part-time jobs. It's really sad. And he was wanting to know, can you do the music for us?
We need you to, don't have anyone to do the music. So if you could do the music for us. The microphone's not working, Broden.
Broden Kelly.
Can we get the microphone on? There we go.
Broden Kelly.
Wow, okay, I'm going to give this to Joe Kosky, because for this, up until this point, no one has heard him.
Oh, live television, folks.
It's crazy.
Joe, we've got your little
music. Please, we really need someone to do the music.
So we're going to get you to do the music, Joe Kosky. We're going to get you to do the music for us,
tonight,
please.
Tonight is surprises and cavalcade requests.
We didn't really know what to do. We've given you a bunch of sound effects and some outdated dubstep. If you can just press play on it, that'd be sick. But please get off the guest seat. Just get off.
Get out of here.
Right,
so Joe Kosky will be playing us a song later on.
Hey.
And let's
Boys, enough. So I think you know what tomorrow is. It's a very special day. Tomorrow is a very special day for a lot of special people. It's our national Tuesday.
Which we love Tuesdays because it's a day after Monday. And it's a lot of fun to on the day after Monday, have a nap, see a movie, visit a loved one, bury secrets in the backyard, and you can do, it's great. So
what we're going to do is we're going to have a couple of snags in commemoration of Tuesday.
Couple of good old-fashioned Aussie snags.
Come with us. As we've made a snag place.
Come on.
Hey guys, that's the back of Zach.
Come on.
Here we go. Hey.
And we got here the one and only Stu Daulman.
Hey,
Stewie Daulman and Demi Lardner.
Demi Lardner, ladies and gentlemen. Demi Lardner. So, Stewie Daulman, what are you doing for us here today?
Cooking up a couple of snags. We'll have them ready in a few hours, boys.
Oh, yeah, we got some bread. Can we have a couple of snaggies?
Have a couple of snags. They're not quite done yet, but we'll be having a couple of snags soon.
Well, I can't wait, because I'm snags.
And Demi Lardner's here.
How are you, Demi Lardner?
Demi Lardner.
Right. And also, a big shout out going to the big layer, the Sauvignon Blanc in Adelaide Hills, like Demi Lardner.
Demi Lardner.
So we also got to have some bevvies.
Well, because ladies and gentlemen, we got in a little bit of trouble last year. A little bit in trouble for having too many beers. We had too many beers.
We're on this
in
camera.
We had too many beers, and what we did was we just had
had too many beers. So what we're going to do now is we're going to not have beers. We're not going to be irresponsible. Instead, we've replaced what we've replaced it with is instead of beers, we're going to have a couple of red skin vodka shots.
All right, we made these fresh
red
for everyone.
Skin vodka shots.
They are. It's re- would like so who would like a red skin vodka shot?
Would you like a red skin vodka shot, Broden?
And,
or
maybe a chilled glass. All right, Broden just went for
Broden's
it.
Broden's gone for it. I instead
it's
have.
It's usually nice to wait for your friends.
I'm going
to
have instead a nice, delicious glass of Adelaide Hills Sauvignon Blanc,
ladies and gentlemen.
So, all right.
Boys,
are we not
looking good, boys?
Yeah,
guys,
they're coming
looking good. All right.
So, guys, Australia Day.
So obviously today we've got to be safe. We've got to be safe. So we've organised a nurse. Unfortunately, we've organised a nurse shark.
Oh, far out. That is the worst. That is the worst.
We've organised the nurse shark.
Oh my God!
That was scary.
Oh, so scary. I was supposed to organise a nurse. It was supposed to be a nurse, and it ended up being a nurse shark.
A nurse shark.
I love that joke.
Guys, just cheers to Tuesday.
Hey, we're going today.
Great day to. Oh,
thanks, guys. We'll be back.
Goodbye,
stay tuned.
We'll be back. We're sorry.
Aunty Donna.
Ah! We're still going! Ah. We're still going!
I was watching the split. Because if you come out here...
I think we're good now.
There's more show to come, you flaming mongrels. Don't forget to use the official hashtag on all your tweets, you bloody dickheads. Nah, you were right, mates. We'll see you after the break. After the break.
I want to take a second to thank our official sponsors, Razor Scooters!
Razor Scooter has been supplying scooters to the Channel 31 community for over 30 years. Thank you, Razor Scooter. And
you know what they say, if you're a sick kid, not like actually sick, not in the hospital.
But if you're sick
but
and
if
you want to
cool,
ride
it. But even if you are in the hospital, Razor Scooters.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're broadcasting live today from Adelaide, Hobart. And if you want to call in, you can. The number to call is 9660-3131. That number again is 9660-3131.
I'd like to take a second to talk about the hashtag.
Let's talk about the hashtag.
Everyone
the
out there's on the Twitter, from Ricky Gervais to your uncle that used to chase you around the house with a knife and threaten to cut off your penis. Everybody loves Twitter, and we love Twitter. So if you want to get in on Twitter, just hashtag us. Just send us a tweet on the hashtag. And the hashtag that we're using this evening is hashtag Aunty Donna live on About Tonight on Channel 31 on January 25th, which is Australia Day Eve. And this is the official hashtag for the show. Please look at us 1111111. So if you want to hashtag us and send us a tweet on that hashtag, that should be coming up on the screen now.
Just to hit that hashtag.
Send us a hashtag.
Oh, I think we've got our first caller, ladies and gentlemen.
First phone call.
Let's pick up the phone.
Do I have to pretend that this is the phone?
Let's use this phone.
Okay. Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hello.
I feel like there's two people who are talking. Hello?
Hello, this is Napoleon Bonaparte.
Oh, hello, Napoleon Bonaparte.
I am a biggie pun.
Oh, what was your name again?
Mark, are you really concerned or are you actually just pretending to be?
I'm a little bit concerned because there seems to be a different person on my phone.
Maybe hang
and
up
Zach. And someone else on Zach's phone. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to hang up on this person who hasn't got yet that we're talking to someone else.
How rude,
and we're going to continue with
if
Broden.
If you're going to call, don't be a rooting jury.
I'll tell you what, guys, live TV, you never know what's going to happen.
Just, a regular Mac. Rogue
yes.
Who's this bloody French bloke on the phone?
Let me do my character.
I'm so sorry, Broden. Right.
Hello. Hello, what's your name?
My name is...
Angus, stop!
Stop!
Angus, stop!
Everybody, Mark, sit back in your little seat here.
We're doing a bit.
It's going on too long.
Hello, what's your name?
This is Napoleon Bonaparte.
What was your name again?
Napoleon Bonaparte.
Okay.
Oh, so wait, sorry.
My name is
Neapolitan Bonaparte.
Hello, Neapolitan Bonaparte.
And finally, we've gotten to the sketch.
And what do you do with yourself, Neapolitan Bonaparte?
This has not gone as I thought it would go, so I might just hang up the
phone. Oh, no, but you look very funny on the monitor. Trust me on this one. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Neapolitan Bonaparte.
Can you play that boing sound again?
Oh, what a royal boner that's happened tonight on live television.
I've got to go now. Bye.
Goodbye. Neapolitan Bonaparte.
Hey, guys, what happened? I was just off doing some work.
I was just talking to a new friend of mine. He's both a general of the French army and also three delicious flavours of ice cream.
Thank you. Now we're going to take...
not that phone. This phone.
Oh, is the phone ringing?
That's real phone calls.
And it's a Samsung. As you can see, it's a very modern phone. What they've tried to do is dress the setup, make it look like it's an old phone and cool.
So this is...
really it doesn't... Oh, we got a snag ready?
Don't touch that. Don't touch it.
Not ready yet? All right, thank you,
Stuart. Not ready yet.
Thank you, Stuart Daulman.
Don't touch it. We're going to get in trouble.
Okay.
All right.
So if the...
Spit of gel.
Thank you very much. I want to look good for live TV.
Okay, we got another caller, I think. Ring, 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 ring.
Is the phone ringing?
We got another caller. Let's see who it is.
Hello?
Who was that bloody dessert bloke on earlier?
Oh, dessert? I think you might be talking about me, Dad. Is that you,
it's
Dad?
It's Mark's dad.
It's Mark's dad. I'm very disappointed in general.
What? Disappointed in the general Napoleon? Or just disappointed in me because I don't know what I'm doing?
The last sketch, mate.
Oh, that's goofy.
What a boner.
Can you tell your dad, we have to go because we're going way over time?
So what's happened is, Dad, is we tried to do one sketch, two sketches happened at the same time. It's been a royal boner, and we've got to go, and we'll talk to you soon.
Live television is hard. I don't know how Rove Live did it.
Good night.
Great. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go speak to some very special people, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go out here, and we're going to speak to... Ladies and gentlemen, we have a great competition in this country for the Melbourne International Comedy Festival. It's called Raw Comedy. And we have the winners of all the Raw Comedy, starting with Demi Lardner. Angus Gordon, who won it last year.
Stuart, you won nothing.
You didn't win shit, Stu.
Matt Stewart won it. Jess Perkins came third. And last but definitely not least, Lewis. We're from Lessons with Lewis. Hello, how are you?
Thank you. That was in 2012.
Yes, and what have you done since then?
I've applied for a lot of jobs.
Oh,
great. Jess, you don't have to be here. It's fine. It's the winners. It's for the winners.
That's great.
No one can hear me because I don't have a microphone. Can I have a microphone, please?
Yes, great. Jess, you go sit in the third place.
I said before that we were going to a break, but we weren't. We lied. What we have here of all the winners
of Raw Comedy.
Should we play the package? Come over here.
No, I've been told not to play the package, but should we play the package?
Can we play the package?
Let's play the package. Let's play the package.
Can you give me a...
Oh, my mouth's half full of blood. That's a dying optimist.
My favourite thing about karma is that since bad things happen to bad people, I no longer have to feel guilty about doing bad things anymore, you know, because people have it coming to them, right?
Just the other day, I bought a six-pack of yogurt. It's cost-effective, you guys. It's cheaper than buying six individual yogurts.
I remember when I was a kid, if I was being naughty, my mum would hit me over the head with a wooden spoon, and I'd say, oh, I just don't think you should be punishing me with a symbol of your own oppression.
Sorry?
But the police, you can arrest...
I'm 30 years old from Brunswick, Victoria.
Amazing segue.
I've drunk too much water because I was anxious.
Well...
Yeah.
Maybe I'm hearing myself in delay. Let's go back out there to the boys and the Raw
Come on,
Comedy.
Everybody.
Okay.
Here's the go. Do we have the stuff, Broden? Do we have the
material? We got the thing.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, raw comedy is an amazing and exciting opportunity for so many young Australian comedians. We've now got the best young Australian comedians in the room, but who is the best Australian young comedian who is young? Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to find out.
So here's a sharp object. I'm going to drop that on the ground. First one to it, and battle it out for yourselves, guys.
We're going to cut to an ad break now, and last one living gets to do, I guess, a 5-minute set or something. So
go now.
Just go for
go
it.
Now.
Get to do a set on Channel 31.
Cut to ad.
So cut to an ad break now.
No. Cut to an ad. Cut to an ad.
They'll be ready in 5.
Cut to an ad.
This is fucking loose.
Melbourne, how are we doing? So, when we last left you, we were going to see who the best... Oh, give me a little kisses, like a little kitten on my back. We last left you, we were going to find out who the best raw comedian was. So now we're going to cut over and see who the winner was. All right.
Let's see who won.
Okay.
Oh, Matt.
Yay!
Matt Stewart!
Congratulations!
You win a chance to do a 5-minute set. Come on, mate.
Come on, let's do some comedy. Come on. Oh, wow.
Matt, how does it feel to win?
Feels good?
Come in.
Come on, mate. What are you doing? You won.
Oh, you won.
Winner of raw comedy. Let's leave him to do it, guys.
All right, let's leave him.
He wins. Go for it, Matt. Good work.
He gets to do a tight... Zach, you're right
Zach,
on the camera.
For the love
right.
of okay. God.
You get to do a 5-minute set of raw comedy. Congratulations. Everyone else is dead.
All right, here we go. All Matt Stewart, everyone. Let's make Stewart, him feel everybody. Welcome.
You made me wear a white shirt.
We thought you'd be covered in blood.
There's the blood. So much more.
Come you on, okay? mate, get with the fun.
Type 5, let's go. I'll time you. What's that?
It's the weapon.
I don't want to touch that. I don't want to be part of that.
Matt,
well
you've ruined
done,
the show.
Matt.
You've
oh, Jesus.
Show, mate.
Don't touch that.
Oh, no snags.
Oh, we got a snag.
We got a snag.
All right, come on. It's time for Matt to do his comedy bits.
All right, come on, Matt. Do the wombat bit.
Yeah, do the bit about the
Start
superheroes.
Start with the wombat bit, move on.
I'm not going to do puns.
Okay. Why not?
He's got puns, it's all good.
Come on, mate.
Jess Perkins is going to be the next big thing.
She's the next big dead.
So, come on.
Shouldn't have stabbed her in the throat.
I found her notes.
You wanted this. This is all you.
This is for Jess.
Would you prefer to be out there dead?
Yes.
Do your bit!
Get him out of here. Get him out of here.
No, let him
get
do
him
his
out
bit!
Of here.
I don't know.
Do your bit!
I've never been one for drugs, but I often wonder what it would be like if I tried to buy drugs. I'd probably just be overly polite.
Very witty!
Jess's bit. She did it better than that.
Yeah, well, she did, mate. But now you've murdered her. Yeah, so.
You get all of their bits.
Hello, I was hoping to exchange some currency for some of the drugs.
This is horrific. Who's this?
This is Jess.
This is horrific.
I will have one heroin, please.
Sir?
I don't even know.
All right.
I will have one heroin, please.
Matt, you're ruined, ladies and gentlemen.
I'll get rid of him.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to get another phone call now. We've got another phone call.
Oh, we got another phone call.
We've got another phone call, ladies and gentlemen. This is from a fan back home. He's got a very interesting name. Let's give him. Oh, hey, Broden. You're just in time with your little bald head.
See you again.
All right, if you wanted to sit down, bro. Okay.
So who's the fan?
All right, let's give him a ring. Ring, ring, ring. Hello.
Hello, who am I speaking to?
Oh, hello. You're speaking to Zach Wayne from sketch comedy troupe Aunty Donna. I also work at a cinema part-time.
Hello, this is Count Dagula.
Count Dagula? You mean Count Dracula?
No, I'm Count Dagula, but Dracula, but a little bit daggy. Oh. And I have the same accent as Neapolitan Bonaparte.
Oh, that's very good.
I'm also on the line.
He's also on the line.
I already told you, you're not allowed to pick that phone up.
Oh, sorry, the Samsung?
Please don't. What is that?
Is that a sound effect?
That's a silly sound effect.
Jesus.
It's very funny. Hey, Zach.
Yeah?
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you, Count Dagula. Hey, you're not going to suck my blood, are you?
No, I might just be a little bit daggy. Oh, like, who are you looking at when you look off camera, Zach?
Oh, let's show them. Come on, where's the camera?
Don't
bring the camera along.
Come over
here. Don't turn the camera towards me.
No, not to you. Oh, I was looking at you.
Right. Oh, don't turn the camera over here.
No, this is a caller from Glen Ferry.
Okay.
All right, Count Dagula, you got any more bits?
I'm pretty sure this is it.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
I'll see you later, chat.
Oh, my God.
Call from your dad.
Okay.
Hey, what happened, guys?
Oh, nothing much. Nothing much, Broden Kelly.
Broden, it's good to have you back. Boy,
I'm getting another phone call.
Was that a goof and a half?
I'm getting another phone call, I think, from my dad. Hello, Dad. Hello, Dad.
Yeah?
Is Dad?
All right. Stuart Daulman there.
You got a microphone, Dad?
Yeah, I'm your dad.
All right, Dad. What's up, mate?
Just chilling out.
Oh, that's great, Dad. Are you enjoying your trip to New Zealand?
Yeah.
Hey, I just want to thank you, Dad.
I've got to tell you something, Zach.
Yeah?
The old noggin's giving me the old bloody run around.
Yeah. And hey, Dad, thank you for lending me that money to pay for the bond. You know, it's hard being a comedian and everything, and I really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I just want to thank you.
I'm going to need that back.
Yeah, no, I'll pay you back, I promise.
No, like...
Do you want to talk to my dad?
Sure. Hello, Zach's
dad. Yeah, all right. Hey, how are you, Mark?
You've got soft lips, don't you?
The softest.
What's it like eating a peach with those lips?
It's heaven.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you get your. Do you wrap your lips around it?
You should try a crayfish with them, one of these New Zealand crayfishes.
A bloody crayfish! Yeah. Zach's dad, can I ask you, can I borrow some money from my bond?
Yeah.
No. Is that a what?
No, man.
Why?
That was a really embarrassing and hard time in my life 2 weeks ago.
I'm moving into a new place in St Kilda. It's 3 minutes walk to the Yarra Station.
You said yes, Zach.
Okay. What? Zach's dad?
Yeah?
Yeah.
He said it's all right?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Okay, great, fantastic. Okay. Well, I am so excited that I'm going to pay my bond with the peach-eating soft-lip man.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen.
So thank you so much.
Is the camera working in here?
Ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, guys, come into the desk in here,
Let's
guys.
Go into the desk room, shall we, guys? We want to show you a bit of behind
the
scenes how we actually make Channel 31 work, all right? So come on, come with us. Here we go. Come through. Let's go on an adventure. Let's find out what's happening in the back room.
Welcome to the future of television. Channel 31, where the future exists, where there's a big, bright future. Wow. What's your name, madam?
Bridget.
Bridget, wow. And what do you love most about being in television?
I love working for free.
You love working for free.
Well, I'll tell you. Hey, good luck getting a house in this century, mate. Good luck getting a house in that century with this attitude.
Lewis! Lewis! What are you doing out there?
Just having a look, I'm a bit bored.
You what?
I'm a bit bored.
What do you mean you're bored? We're live on TV. We're having a great show.
What's the roving doing? Can
you get
anything on that?
Yep. Oh,
you're good. I'm gonna try and get some stuff. All right, guys, come on, let's go.
Come on, let's front up. Hey, Stewie, how those snags coming along?
We're gonna sit down. Come on.
Yeah, they'll be ready. Oh,
Broden,
looking good.
Let's have a look at those snags, shall we? Oh boy.
Guys, I gotta be honest with you.
They're coming up all right.
I'm feeling a little bit drunk. I don't know if there's anything that can help.
Maybe a Redskin vodka shot.
All right, but anything else, huh?
Oh yeah, maybe, hey guys, I'm just about to cut to the grey nurse. So maybe get the grey nurse ready. Are you feeling sick, Zach?
Hey mate, I'm feeling a little bit sick. Is there any sort of nurse that can look after me?
Yeah, why don't you get the grey nurse? I'm just gonna stay here until you do it.
Guys, this is what happens when you don't communicate very well.
Oh no, it's
a great nurse.
With people.
Zach, you need to lay down.
Zach. Have another bloody drink.
Oh, it's
Zach.
A great nurse.
Really
lay down.
Right. Think.
Ladies and
guys,
gentlemen.
Guys, I've got some bad news. Since we cut to the grey nurse, cut to the grey nurse again.
Cut to the grey nurse. I'll tell you what, we're making these people
cut to the grey nurse.
Their asses off.
Yeah. Oh, it's
horrible. My God, it's terrifying.
Ladies and gentlemen, that, look at that. Why is he out of the water? Anyway, guys, since we cut to the grey nurse, unfortunately, 3 minutes left. Are you kidding me? This is the longest segment in the world.
I swear.
What happened?
Oh, God.
Guys,
I tell you what happened.
No, you.
Guys, I've got some bad news. Since we cut to the grey nurse, cut again.
Cut to the grey nurse. Cut to the grey nurse. Cut to the grey.
Yeah. What?
Oh, the grey nurse.
Movie.
It just looks like a weird. Where's the dorsal fin? It's further back. What is that bird? Guys, we just want to take a minute to thank our sponsors, Razor Scooters.
That's heaps people.
Razor Scooters are a top-line scooter. If you want to, I broke my ankle a couple of times riding on a Razor scooter.
Mark, I got bad news.
What happened?
That's what I've been trying to say. Is unfortunately, Zach passed away.
Oh no.
Zach, how long have you been passed away? How long have you been passed away for?
I'm so sad.
I died from alcohol poisoning about 20 seconds ago.
Not Zach, yeah. He's my best friend.
Can I just say, can we get the camera on me right now?
Can we get a special?
No, can we get Zach. A special? Guys, I asked a good mate of ours, Greg Larson, to be on the show, but
I
said Australia Day. I said the same thing to Demi Lardner. I said Australia Day. We were filming on Australia Day Eve.
Zach's my best friend.
I got to be honest with you, I fucked up. And now we've got to fill an 8-minute segment at the top of a 90-minute show.
Zach, yeah? Can you give me your top 10 reasons why they shouldn't shut down Channel 31?
Give me your top 10 reasons why I love Zach!
What? It's a great learning educational ground for RMIT
why
gives
good
students.
Hugs.
Yeah.
Two. Rudolph Giuliani. Wah, 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 wah. Three.
He's got a great ass.
Three. I really think I overshot it.
Three. He's got soft lips like his dad.
Four. You know, we're just making a comedy.
Four. I shit my pants.
A bottle of vodka. And we're only 20 minutes into the 90-minute show.
I swear we prepared more than this. Jeff, from the bottom of my heart,
guys,
we've got to run shit.
Mark.
And this isn't in it.
Mark, gather around.
We didn't get the scooters until about 10 minutes ago.
Mark,
gather
come here.
Around.
Gather
what?
In.
Zach
Mark,
Wade.
Mark, quick. 5 seconds. We're going to cut to a very welcome break, but stick around for more top quality community programming.
It's just like Rove, but.
Malcolm Turnbull, eat your heart out. This is where the real quality is.
Are you on Twitter and Facebook? Well, so are we. And we're as dry as a dead dingo's dunger. So chuck us a like or a follow. Come on, don't be a tight ass. See you after the break.
Comedy.
Comedy.
Don't just... Hey, Joe, how are you going?
Oh, my God. Joe.
Mate.
Guys,
if you'd given me the
we got a phone call.
Well, give me the tools.
Let's take the phone call. I'll talk about this later.
All right.
Is this going to be on in the studio? Can I hear this?
Hello, you're on air. No, you're not on air.
In the phone.
Hello.
I have pressed the speaker button.
We can hear it. Can you hear it in the office?
Hello. Do I hear it? Can I? I don't even have an earpiece.
Lewis, shut up.
Shut up, Lewis.
Sorry.
Your bit is coming, Jesus.
All
right, hello.
Well, I'm trying to make this show work.
Hello. We got it. We can share. We can share.
But they can't hear.
They can't hear.
No. Speaker.
They weren't prepared. I brought balloons, but they can't,
hello?
They can't even work a speaker for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is what happens when you do live theatre, but also
there?
Do Redskin vodka shots. Sometimes things
I'm sorry,
go
I think you have to go.
Wrong.
Maybe call back.
And
bye.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, wait, hello!
Wait, hello!
Hello, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, this is great.
Great, that's great.
Okay, so you just stay. Zach, you say about how to call us.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we've got our first real live caller ever for our entire lives. But if you also want to be a live caller, if you want to interact with the Aunty Donna experience, just call 9660-3131. That number again is 9660-3131. Or maybe you want to tweet in. Maybe you want to just have a little tweet with us on the Twitter sphere. And that's really easy. We're just going to pull up our hashtag now. Just write your comment, write your tweet, and then do the hashtag. Hashtag Aunty Donna Alive on About Tonight on Channel 31 on January 25th, which is Australia Day Eve. And this is the official hashtag for the show. Please use it to talk to us 1111. That's the hashtag. You can also just do at Aunty Donna Boys.
Are you done?
Or I think there's a Channel 31 one. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the way to get in contact
and
with
what's
us.
What's your name, sir?
My name's Jack.
Hey, Jack.
Jack.
What are you doing?
I'm in my bedroom.
What are you doing?
Ooh, naughty boy.
Ooh, la la, Glenn McGrath.
Bit of me time.
Joe just chiming in. I like it. So what are you doing what are you doing in your bedroom?
What are you doing, Joe?
Jack? I was just thinking up a question to ask you lot.
Yeah, what's the question?
If you could go on a nice candlelit dinner with Australian celebrity, B-grade celebrity,
easy.
Who would it be, mate?
Glenridge, thank you, bye.
Alicia Cuthbert.
That's the end of that call there.
Alicia Cuthbert from 24 season 1 and 2, she was a babe.
You done?
I'm done, I'm sorry.
Oh, there's another call. All right. Hello?
It's like we have our own show.
No, I don't understand how this phone works. So we're going to cut to our first guest. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the biggest names in Australian television, ladies and gentlemen. He's hosted Good Morning Australia. He's hosted The Block. Please welcome Lessons with Lewis.
Thank you so much. Hello, Broden. How are you today?
Now, Lewis.
Thank you for having
me. Lessons with Lewis.
Yes.
You have a bit of a history with this show, is that right?
That's right.
A history. Last time I was invited, last Australia Day, I had a little chat with Mark and he got very upset at me and started shouting at me, which then followed with tweets that were quite mean.
What were the tweets? What happened?
The tweets Lessons involved a lot of swear words and a lot of F words.
What swear words specifically?
I don't want to repeat them.
Which ones?
Thank you so very just very rude ones.
Okay.
Someone else can say them, but I don't think we can say those words at this time slot, ladies and gentlemen.
How would you like to make amends?
I would love to make amends. Mike was messaging me and he was actually saying nice things this time.
Okay,
so I believe we have a little ceremony for Mike to actually apologize to me live on television.
Okay,
is that
sure.
Right?
So let's take the young man through. Ladies and gentlemen, Mark Bonanno.
Play the music. It's like a wedding special, but about friendship.
How are you, by the way?
I'm okay.
Oh, yeah,
that's
great.
Not the wedding special music.
So
he's got a friend in me.
He upset some people. He upset this young boy last season. Check it out. We'll put the link if we do this ever online. But now he's going to make amends with
an old
Sicilian
and
tradition.
It's going to be a good time.
It's going to be beautiful.
I'm misunderstood because he says swear words sometimes, but sometimes when people say nice or bad things...
Come on, let's do this, Lewis! Oil up, mate! Me and you, we're wrestling. This is how we apologise. Come on, did you bring your own oil? Come on! What's wrong? Let's do this! We'll wrestle, we're gonna wrestle! You wanna have a wrestle?
I brought you gifts, Mark.
Gifts? I brought you the gift of apology through wrestling. So I need you to take off your clothes and strip down. Did you bring your dance support?
I brought you balloons, Mike.
Okay, thank you.
I didn't ask Sam.
Now, I've put the balloon next to my penis.
I brought you a little heart.
Come on, man. This is how we say sorry in Italy.
This is not how we say sorry, Mike. You told me in
what? What? Why are you mad? I said this is how we say sorry.
To be very
Come on. Come on. Put the microphone down. Come on. Strip down. Strip down.
Why not? Why not?
Don't touch me.
How do you apologize in Spain?
We're supposed to accept the gift. This is my heart for you.
Come on, Lewis! How else do you want to do this?
Ah,
wait! What the fuck is that?
It's a cat boot with
no tail. Oh my God, get it away from me. Come on, do you want me to help you with your belt? Come on. Come on, Lewis. Why? Why? Come here. Give me this. Someone take the mic. Someone take the mic. We are going to be friends, but we got to wrestle.
No.
We got to wrestle. Come on.
No.
Yes?
First,
I got to get him into a...
No.
Lewis! No. Stop!
No.
Stop crying! Crying is not for boys!
Stop it!
No! Crying is for people who just found out their nan has tumbled down the stairs! Alright? And they're worried about her health! Crying is for clouds! When it's raining, that's a cloud crying! No, it's not, Lewis! Alright, you can cut away now!
Okay, alright. Take a phone call!
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, what the fuck are you doing here, Jess? Get out! What the fuck is Jess doing here? Jesus Christ. Hey guys, welcome back to the show. Now, we're about to take a phone call from a very prominent author. Not
well, let's
one.
Take
Hang
this real phone call.
All right, we're taking a real phone call.
I was going to do another pun thing.
No, you've got to be careful.
All right, ready?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Hey, who's this?
It's Lachlan Boland.
Now, listen, I've never worked in radio or television before, yet we've been given an hour and a half to do this, but you have to turn down your television, I'm pretty sure.
Lachlan,
you're listening to your television.
I'm on my television.
Lachlan, what are you doing?
I'm having a bevy.
Yeah.
Oh, you're having a bevy with the boys.
Yeah.
And why don't you tell me about the what kind of bevy are you having? Bye. All right, Jack, take another call.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to take another phone call. Lachlan, we do love you, but you know that's the thing. So we're about to take another phone call from another person, and let's see who this one is. Ring, 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 ring. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. What was your name?
My name is Salman Rushdie.
What was that again, sorry?
Salman Rushdie.
Salman Rushdie? What do you do, Salman Rushdie?
I said the real name again.
What do you do, Salman Rushdie?
Salman Rushdie, I am a fishy.
Yes.
And I am in a rush. I'm in a big rush.
So you're a prominent author.
Yes, I'm a prominent author.
A controversial one. We won't go into that.
No, we won't go into that.
And,
but I have to go
but
now.
But also, you're a fishy
in
a bit of a rush. Tell me about that, Salman Rushdie.
Well, I don't want to delve into it too much.
Yes.
Mainly because I have not looked into it beyond this simple pun. Look at Broden Kelly there. He's just looking at the laptop.
Yes,
he looks
absolutely
a little bit different.
Absolutely.
Oh, Mark is back, it looks like.
It's Salman Rushdie. Would you like to talk to him?
Sure. Do you have anything beyond the pun?
No, Mark.
All right, goodbye. Salman Rushdie, everyone. And, Broden, where were you?
I was just off camera pretending to be Salman Rushdie.
Well, guys, can we please cut over? Let's check up on the barbecue.
We're going to break.
Oh, we're going to break. We'll check on the barbecue when we get back.
Please stay tuned for the love of God.
I'm drunk.
Goodbye.
We know that.
Oh, man. I'm real drunk.
And we're back! Australia, Melbourne and Geelong. How are you all today? So good to see you. What a exciting, unexpected night it's been for everyone, most of all us. Before we get on to our next segment, which believe or not we do actually have, we're just going to do a little bit of a plug for our major sponsor. Zach?
Ladies and gentlemen, Razor Scooter. Since 1997, Razor Scooter has been making the lives of young children the most wonderful and beautiful lives. I had a Razor Scooter in my country house and I wasn't really able to use it. Matt's decided to sit in. Ladies and gentlemen, Razor Scooter. Thank you.
Okay, hey, Stewie Daulman, how are those snags going, mate?
Yeah, can we cut the stew, check up on the barbecue?
Snags going really good, guys. They seem to form a triangle, which is true to nature, true form. There's three prongs.
Let's have a look at those snags.
Yeah, so you got a triangle, Illuminati confirmed. Oh,
get the camera off that.
They're looking
the camera
good.
Off that.
They're looking good.
Illuminati confirmed.
Oh, okay. Wow. See who is.
Hey, Demi.
They look great.
When you break up with your girlfriend, you really start to look into things quite deeply. That's the fucking thing. So,
are you okay?
Stu, are you all right, mate?
I'm
fine.
Demi,
you could have the wine?
Fine,
who said
I'm
you
fine,
could have
Demi.
The wine?
Demi, I'm fucking fine, man.
Who said you could have the wine?
Demi. Mark, guys, I think Stu's upset.
Who said you could
Stu?
Have the wine?
Another shout out going to Kosuka Chips.
Yep.
Oh, they're so good.
All right, cut away from Stu. Bring him back to the studio, please.
Okay,
thank you.
That was
for the
really
love
good.
Of God. Thank
okay,
you,
Okay, we're
Stu.
Sitting here with Jess Perkins and Matt Stewart, who's still recovering from the death of Jess Perkins. Jess, how are you today?
Great. So we are going to be playing a game.
It's game time.
Everybody
loves the game.
Everybody loves the game time. Hello there. Who's on the phone? It's Mr. Game. And what do you know? It's game time.
Game time.
Everybody loves the game time.
All right.
So let's all make sure our hair is nice and done before we start up game time. Thank you very much. Yeah. Just want to make sure looking nice and good for TV.
Okay, Jess. Have you heard? Get the fuck up. Have you heard of a game called Party Quakes, Jess Perkins?
Yes.
Jess.
I'm scared of cameras.
Don't be afraid of cameras. There's not many.
Don't be afraid,
there's
Jess.
There's just one there, and there's one there.
Yep.
And there's one there.
There's another one.
And there's one there. And there's one there. And there's one there. And there's one there.
Jess, just want to shake your hand if I could. Gotcha, it's full of grease.
Hands full of grease.
Boing, gotcha!
All right, so you know the game Party Quakes.
Dingus!
They did it on... you. Knock my earpiece out.
Sorry.
That's okay.
We
so
love
they do this game
Jess
on.
Jess is a really a great up and coming comic. We really
she's up.
Check her out at the Melbourne International.
Shut up, Zach. Zach's all right. Zach's not well. So this game is called Party Quirks. Jess is going to host a party, and we're going to come in as zany goofball characters, and it's her job to guess which characters we're playing.
It's
going to
be so much fun. It's a game very popular on the television show. Who? Thank God you're here. And we're very much looking forward to playing this with Jess Perkins.
Just turn my microphone on.
Okay, can you do that for us, please?
Jess,
is
your microphone on?
Sure is.
Great.
Yeah, confirmation that Jess's
microphone
is working.
Is on.
Okay, so we've got 3 minutes to play this game.
Okay.
Jess, you're going to start your party. Joe, can we get some music? And then
some
you're going to hear some knocks
music.
On the door. And then we're going to come in and play some roles. And you've got to guess what we are.
But I'll tell you what, for the guests at home, our quirks will be appearing on the bottom of the screen.
You know I can see the screen.
But you can't read that.
Don't
can you
yeah,
not
we're
look?
Not going to be able to read
can
it
you
because
not look
you're
at
illiterate.
Chess?
Okay,
all
I
right.
won't look at it.
Please.
All right.
Please don't
so,
look.
So, I believe I'm going first.
Joe,
I'm just
some
gonna
music.
Get some props.
Jess is leaving the shot. Jess left the shot.
Thanks.
No, I can't have
no, you can't do that.
Hang
you
on.
Can't.
Hang on.
I ain't getting shit.
No, stop it, Zach.
Yeah, all right,
sorry about that. Jess Perkins, who is needed for this segment, has...
Alright,
fucked
great.
Off and now she's back. Please don't do that again.
Sorry.
Alright, quick, we have to make this quick. Go! Okay. Knock on the door!
Who is it? Hello.
Oh, hello. I'd love to shake your hand, but I can't.
Hello, octopus?
Oh, no, I wish I was an octopus. I'm much less formed than that.
A jellyfish?
Oh, very close. There's another
jelly.
Knock on the door.
Jelly.
Very good.
Who else is here?
Well, what's all
party?
This nonsense?
It's Broden.
Nice clothes, but no cigar. Hi, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Great. I'm sorry to hear about your uncle.
Are you a priest?
No, not at all.
Are you Broden's
but I
dad?
Am a caramel. Okay, wobble, wobble, wobble. Hey, great party.
This is
what
confusing.
Am I? All right. Oh. Oh. Oh, I'm ready for the war.
Oh. An accent. I'm detecting an accent. And a lot of this as well. Who is it? Excuse me. Guests, I have another guest to attend to. Hello, sir. Welcome to the party.
I travel to the city of which I wish to visit. This is a city important to me in this land. But beep, 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 beep,
I'd love to shake your hand, but I can't.
No, we've already established your jelly.
Oh, yeah, you got me.
Come on, have a guess. Matt, can you give me a hand with this? Do you have any idea what's going on right now? something booping. Broden's gone. You've got to give me more than making a book noise.
Well, Jess is having a guess. Let's cut over to the barbecue. See what's happening. All right. So Broden Kelly's lost his mind. Great. How are the snags coming up? Keep going.
They go. Yeah, they go pretty good. That's number nine. That's how many months I was going out with my girlfriend.
Oh. Oh my.
Didn't work.
That's all right. Let's. Hey, you know, it's tis the season.
Let's come back. Let's see how this game's going.
Well, I was.
What do you mean? Every time we have
a party.
Let's come back. All right.
I've fallen out of the mic.
Whatever you want to do.
You're saying it's a problem that I'm drunk right
now. Every single time we have a party, you get drunk, and then you go, "Is there a problem that I'm drunk right now?" And it's like, yeah, Zach. It
doesn't matter
who we introduced. The concept.
Doing what they want to do. Broden Kelly just fucking goes off.
Let's cut back. Let's cut back.
I'm out here trying to entertain.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm serious. This is embarrassing. You're on television. Broden's being a dick. And you're bloody drunk again.
You sweaty. I'm really.
Goodbye.
Put on a lot of weight. And people.
Isn't this show the best bloody show on television? Sitting here eating damper, drinking Billy tea, the Sheila sitting next to me. It's a dead set leg opener. How good is this?
I think I got all the cliches in there. Would you like me to go again? Is there anything I missed?
You want to make sure you look good for television. That's what my mum always said. So just getting that done up right there. All right. Okay, how's that looking? Great.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to About Tonight at Aunty Donna's Australia. Would it be fair to assume, I actually don't know what this show is called. I don't know if this is an About Tonight. I don't know if this is an Aunty Donna Australia Day themed show. I just know that it's underprepared, but it's quality television.
And I love dancing. I just love dancing.
Mark, that's a very nice dancing, Mark, and you should be commended for it. Now, Joe, you've turned into a kangaroo.
Yep.
Yes, you have. You're a naughty boy, aren't you? Oh, hey, why don't you wave your... What's your little Joey called?
Oh, dickhead.
Oh, that's a good improvisation, really, Joe the kangaroo. Yeah. Joe, why don't you play a track on your computer?
What kind of track?
Some dub.
Okay. Just give me a sec.
Just keep that good telly coming. Just keep that good
minutes
television coming.
After minutes.
Oh, that's some good
quality
dub.
Television here,
hey,
at Channel 31.
It's probably a good time to just check in with the grey nurse. Here comes the. Then we got a shark. We didn't understand. All right, guys, I want to see how Stewie Dolman's going out on the snags. How are those snags looking, mate?
Yes, snags look great, bro.
Oh, good, they're sizzling away.
Hey. Thanks, Chess. Thank you. Thank you. Mark.
How are they going out there?
Yep. We're cutting over to Stew. Hey, Stewie.
Stewie, how are those snags going?
Tip top, bro.
Oh, it's a love heart now. I thought it was a triangle before.
No, it's not.
Oh, they're coming up good. No. Don't forget that snag.
You want a fucking snag?
Whoa, hey.
You want a fucking snag?
Stop. Oh, my God.
Stuart!
I'll tell you what, when someone's acting like that, best thing to do, forget your troubles, have a drink.
Have a bloody skip of that.
All right, we're going to come back in here. We're going to take a call. We're going to take a call from my mum. Is my mum on the phone? Hello?
Hello?
Is that Leon Kelly?
What are you doing with your life, bro?
I'm hosting a Channel 31 show, mum.
Are you wearing clean underwear?
It's not going the best. Not going the best.
Are you wearing clean underwear? I always told you to wear clean underwear.
Look, I'd be lying if I said I was wearing clean underwear. I believe it's been washed. Annie has been washing it mostly recently, and I couldn't really be across what's been washed.
Is that Mark? Is that Mark there?
Leon!
Mark!
Is this better or worse than last year?
Better.
I don't think it is.
I'm just being nice because I like you better than Broden,
Mark. I feel like we were more underprepared last year and have done worse this year.
There's a lot of people at home who are probably saying, this is inappropriate. This is not my Australia Day.
Oh, Zach's getting into the Redskin vodka again, Zach!
This is what this country has become.
Stop it!
Under a John Howard.
Come on, don't touch a snake! Don't touch a fucking snake!
Exactly. All right, we've had enough of this. John Howard, this is not our Australia. This is not our Australia, Bob Hawke. Here's what we're going to do now. Hey, guys. What we're going to do now is, Melbourne's a great place to live. Melbourne's a great city with great culture. But do you know that this country is split into two different kinds of place. We've got the north side and the south side of this city. Zach actually lives on the south side. He lives in Paran, and Mark, he lives in Fitzroy. Let's find out one by one which side's the better. Take it away, Mark.
I tell you what, I love the north side. That's me.
And can I tell you what, camera one? Zachary Wayne, I love the south side.
And I tell you
what,
that's
for me.
I love the north side. I'll tell you why.
Why?
The shopping district on Brunswick Street.
Excuse me, Mark.
Oh my God.
You heard of the fashion district in the South Yarra end of Chapel Street?
Chapel Street? How about the food on Smith Street, north side for life?
What about the food on the Windsor end of Chapel Street? Yum, yum, yum.
Oh, has Chapel Street got something as cool as the Westgarth Cinema in Northcote?
Let me think. I think Chapel Street has something pretty cool. It's called the Astor Cinema.
How can you compete with Edinburgh Gardens, Northside for life?
Maybe with the St Kilda Beach. We got the ocean and everything.
Oh, yeah? Well, how about IMAX Cinema? The second biggest screen in the world next to Darling Harbour.
Ring, ring, ring. I'm pretty sure the Astor has 70mm cinema.
Now we got another 10 minutes, bro. Sit down, don't worry about it.
Guys, good news. Do you know that on this show we have the winner of the Hottest 100 tomorrow? Please welcome Peking Duck.
It's Peking Duck, ladies and gentlemen.
You're not Peking Duck. What are you doing
what
here?
What are you doing here?
We don't have Peking Duck.
Explain the joke, Sam.
So it was like, there was going to be a thing I would come out with, someone brought out Peking Duck, like the food. But instead of Peking Duck, we have Meepo dry noodle and some wet ones.
Explain the wet ones.
I'd love a wet one, actually.
I don't know. We could do the joke again with like Poe from MasterChef.
Yeah, can we do the joke again with Poe from MasterChef?
All right, guys,
can someone get that on the camera, please? So everyone can see it at home.
The winner of the Triple J Hottest 100, Poe from MasterChef.
Can you get that on camera so people can see that, please?
I'm going to start it again.
Can someone put this on camera,
please, so you
can see this?
Poe from MasterChef.
Someone put this on camera?
Mark, can you give it to Sam? He'll come back in.
All right, we're going to do it again.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Sometimes when you prepare for live television, your friend will get inappropriately drunk
and you have
to get your director, Sam Lingan, to
come on
and do some shit.
Please welcome, from the winner of the Triple J Hottest 100,
it's Poe from MasterChef. Where are the noodles?
I lost them.
I think it's time for a break.
What the fuck? Come on, Sam, get off.
Recoup.
You lost the noodles,
Sam.
You lost noodles.
We're gonna cut to a break.
You're a noodle.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Goodbye, everybody. We'll be back, unfortunately.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's an absolute pleasure to be with you on this Australia Day Eve. What an important part of our culture, what an important day. But first, a word from our sponsors.
Woo! Razor scooters. Ever since I got a Razor scooter, I've fingered 8 girls behind portables.
Oh, Mark, get the fuck off the camera, Mark. Mark.
It's just trying to do a joke and a gag and a goof.
It's not funny, Mark. It's not funny. All right,
it's just my life.
Mark, all right, let's chuck and see how that grey nurse is going. It's awful. Oh, the humanity. Oh, God. It's good.
It's very good. It's very good. Hey, Stewie, how's those snags coming along? I love a snag.
Cutting over to Stewie Dolman. Stewie, what's going on with the snags, boy?
Huh?
What's going on with the snags?
I'm not texting her.
No one's...
Stew?
No one's... Man,
Stew, I'm not really across what happened with your girlfriend.
Come on.
Get off it, Stew. I'll tell you what you need, Stew.
Ah!
Stew needs a Razor scooter.
Oh, scooter, man! Help me cut it out!
Help me get with girls since 92.
Oh, God. Oh, that's a good... Oh,
you go, Stew! You ride that wild heart!
Go, Stew, go!
You ride that thing!
Oh, he's gone. He's getting on the lift. All right, great.
Stew it down,
ladies and gentlemen.
On the scooter. Let's go back to the studio.
Up until this point, this has been your average show. This is Zach, by the way. This has been a really magical show. But we're lucky enough now...
Oh, let's introduce our next guest.
Our next
there you go. There's the happy single man.
Bam!
Riding around on a scooter.
He's back on the horse.
Get back at that scooter, man!
Scooter man.
You go for it, man. You break those hearts. You break
scooter
those hearts.
Scooter man. Stewie Daulman.
Bro, do I give you shit?
Yeah, yeah, bye, Stewie.
Get out of here, Stewie.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're lucky enough to have a great guest on the show. We're going to cut live to
I envy him.
We're going to cut live to God.
God.
Hello.
God, hello.
Hello.
Hi, God. Thank you so much for coming on our show.
Oh, thank you so much for having me, young boys.
God. We are... God. Are you all right, Broden? Sometimes when you see the face of God, you
it
just
can't...
You just can't be good for live television.
Oh, God. You know, Broden.
Yes, God.
When Damascus saw me, he was blinded by the light. Yeah. And now you're going to be blinded by my sweet comedy skills.
Okay. God, are you here plugging anything today?
Yeah, I'm doing a show at the Melbourne International Comedy Festival. It's at the Melbourne Town Hall, which is very exciting. It's at 6 p.m. It's in a little 50-seater.
Where are you?
What's that, sorry?
What venue, sorry?
In the Town Hall.
At the Town Hall.
Yeah. How did you get a Town Hall venue?
Well, you know, I'm God.
Is this your first year?
You got a festival managed venue in your first year and it's Town Hall.
Look, yes. God, we've been doing the festival for about 5 years now, so any questions you got, shoot them at us and we'll help you out, ma'am.
Any questions about the Comedy Festival?
Yeah, absolutely. So I got the festival managed venue mostly because I appeared to the people of the Melbourne International Comedy Festival as a light, a bright light, and I said, give God a 50-seater. A 50-seater.
You wanted to start out small and then sort of work your way up from there?
You don't want to be too pretentious, even if you're
even
the
if
highest
you're God.
Being on earth.
Are you hiring people to fly before the show?
No, I'm going to do it myself.
Yeah, do it yourself.
I'm also
going to
just... I've got a strong Christian crowd, so
yeah, cool.
You know, I think I'm going to get a lot in, you know, like the squeaky clean guys.
Guys, if you have a complaint, please call us up on Channel 31. We can bring the number up on the bottom. Any complaints? Please call through.
God, can you do the hashtag?
Oh, yeah, absolutely, I can.
Can you give the hashtag to God?
Well, I don't know where he is.
All right, so I'm going to do the hashtag now.
It's just here.
Yeah, great. So, hashtag Aunty Donna live on About Tonight on Channel 31 on January 25th, which is Australia Day Eve and is the official hashtag for the show. Please use it to talk to us at 1111. I don't personally use Twitter.
I use the Holy Scripture.
I
have no idea where God is.
God,
you're an interesting character.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about where you grew up?
So I grew up in the township of Wangaratta. I was originally a sheep herder.
Oh, great. Yeah.
I started out the sheep herding. And then I moved. I actually opened a small Baker's Delight there, and everyone they were quite concerned. They said, "God, why are you doing a Baker's Delight in Wangaratta?" And I said, "You know, there's space for it. The Vegemite scrolls—they'll sell well." And by gosh, they did.
They called it Cheesemite scroll, God.
What did I call them?
You called it a Vegemite.
I got to be honest with you. I'm pretty drunk right now.
Okay, well, you're not definitely not in the same studio as us. There's absolutely
no. Absolutely not. I'm so, in heaven.
Because
right
you're in heaven
now.
And we're
don't
down here.
Don't use that shot.
So don't use that fucking camera ball, please.
Don't use that shot.
You're ruining the illusion completely.
That's better.
Okay.
God, so you're from Wangaratta?
Yes, absolutely.
Do you know Michelle Brazier?
No, she's from Wagga.
She's from Wagga.
Yeah, I'm just asking him if he knows her, not because they're from the same place.
She's got a show at the Melbourne International Comedy Festival.
Zach, do you have any questions for God?
Yes. God?
Yes.
Who are your sort of comedy influences?
My comedy influences are Isaiah. My other comedy influences are Moses. And
Angus,
also,
come have a seat.
Angus, have a seat.
Coming at Angus, Angus, do you have a microphone?
My three comedy influences are Isaiah, Moses, and probably Sean McAuliffe.
What about your son? He was big on the comedy circuit
Jesus.
In his day. Yeah,
he was Gary.
Yeah. The trainee.
The forgotten boy.
From when you're out of the chippy.
Gary. No, look, Gary's all right. He's in a bit of an in-between spot at the moment. He studied arts at the University of Ballarat. And the thing about Gary is, like, Jesus, I've got 30 seconds to go. But the thing about Gary is he's having a good go. He's not the son of the Lord, that sort of thing, but he's having a good go, which is important.
Gary, I mean, God, it's been lovely to chat. Unfortunately,
I haven't had a good time. I just want to make that clear.
You know,
this
there
isn't
was a
real.
Lot of jokes
None
I had
of this is
prepared,
real.
But I think that we've had some fun.
None of this
so
we're going to be back in a bit. Stay tuned.
Thanks
Bye.
So much.
Stay tuned.
Thank you.
Thank you, God.
Missed the start of the show? No worries, it'll all be online on our YouTube channel in a couple of days. Might as well subscribe now. And while you're waiting, check out some of our old shows. They're bloody bonza.
All right, Auntie Donna.
And we are on About Tonight. Guys, apparently, right now, we're trending on Twitter. I'm not sure exactly what that means, but if that means we're cool, then thank you very much for everyone that's tweeting.
Thank you, Josh Earl from Spix and Specs Mark 2 for that tweet. And
I know we're trendy on Twitter. Oh, good, here comes someone. All right.
Mark.
Guys, great news. We're going to do some... Oh, Lewis. Hey, Lewis.
Lewis, come in, mate. Hey.
Guys.
Someone's mad at Mark.
Turn that frown
Someone's
upside
mad
down.
At Mark.
I got to be honest with you.
Guys.
Everyone's been pretty mad at us for being a little bit goofball.
Hey, Zach's got a good point, Zach. Do you want to talk about that a bit more?
All right. So here's the thing, right? A lot of people, they get narky at us. They say you're 25 through 43 and you've got a young audience and you're making some pretty negative jokes.
Yeah, we've sworn a lot on this
we've
show
We've sworn
tonight,
a lot. And I Mark guess we said just the cunt word.
No, I didn't actually say the cunt word.
Oh, you didn't? Well,
I
just said the
cunt
word.
And then it didn't happen.
And well, now we're saying the cunt word.
Well, we've probably said it too much.
All right.
Do the quotes.
So what we're going to do tonight, to make up for all these rude words that I've been saying, that Mark's been saying, that some of us have been saying, is we're going to do some inspirational quotes just to bring everyone's mood up a little bit. My personal favourite inspirational
quote
is this little one here. As I look back on my life, I realise that every time I thought I was being rejected
Lewis.
From something good, I was actually being redirected.
Come on,
redirected to something better.
See, that's beautiful, and I love that quote because it's really about sort of how life can take twists and turns, and how, you know, you just got to roll with. One of my favorite quotes ever would be. Be somebody who makes everybody feel like a somebody. And that's, what do you think of that, Broden?
Well, that's funny. That's a funny quote, Mark. And I think I'd like to. Oh, excuse me, I farted.
Was that you?
I think it reminds me of one of my favourite quotes, which is an Oscar Wilde one.
Ah, yes.
Oh,
this is Broden's always breaking out this quote.
I love Oscar Wilde.
It's a little story about being a young Oscar man. Wilde. It's I am not young and... Oh, excuse me.
Jess?
It's
oh
a quote...
Oh, God. I'm sorry.
Thank
Jess,
you, Jess.
Come back.
Don't...
All right.
Don't smirk at
show
Brown,
respect
Jess.
For the quote.
Sorry, all right, and the quote
we're
is...
We're not smirking grade sixes anymore.
The quote is, I am not young enough to know everything.
Mm.
Wow. Excuse- oh, stop!
Oh!
Stuart!
Nurse!
Can we get the nurse? Can we get the nurse,
get the nurse,
please?
Get the nurse!
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 We end all of our About Tonight shows, obviously, with a battle between our top two contestants on the N64 to win an Encyclopedia Britannica. Let's cut to a shot of the N64.
All right, is that...
All right.
We didn't get that up?
Great, let's get a shot of the TV. Can we get a shot of the TV?
Please,
get
let's a shot of the have TV. A look at the TV.
And there it is.
It's okay, yeah. And they're off. Right.
And they're off.
No one's actually, we couldn't get the N64 to work. Just another one of the delightful
it's supposed to be Lewis
happy accidents that's happened tonight.
It's supposed to be Lewis and Demi Lardner. Demi Lardner is not here at all. And Lewis is mad at Mark, I think, with fair reason.
I would disagree there. You know, some people are made for the world of entertainment, and one of them would be lessons with Lewis. And that's just my opinion.
If it's okay, I'm just trying to ask the person in my ear, how long have we got? And they're not even answering me.
Great. You know what, guys? You know what I'd like to do? I'd like to sit down for a second, read a few more inspirational quotes.
I think I'd love to read an inspirational quote or two. Let's read an inspirational quote.
Pardon? One of my personal... Oh, thank you
One
so
of
much,
Mark's
Jess.
Favourite inspirational quotes and my personal inspirational quote is this
Lewis
one.
Lewis is using Siri. Right oh, excuse me.
One of my personal favourite quotes is... Happiness is. Oh my God, Lewis, shut
Lewis,
your fucking
Lewis,
mouth.
Lewis, mate.
Ladies
Lewis.
And gentlemen, we're going to close out the show now. Mark, beans.
That was me that time. I'm sorry, that was totally me.
Can you read the quote to
sure.
me, Mark?
One of my favourite quotes that I love is.
And listen to this, Malcolm Turnbull.
Yeah. Yeah, if you're out there, Malcolm.
With your swipes That's at good. This
Living
sort of
in
media.
Your mansion. Happiness is found when, forgive me, when you stop comparing yourself to other people.
Mm. I think it's a beautiful note to end the show on. We're going to close out the show with one of the most talented men I know and one of my our best friends. His name is Joe Kosky. He's a star of the group Godwolf. Joe, you've got this song coming out. It's a fantastic song. We've just got
where
the
can
fucking
we check
TV
it out, Joe?
Working. We just got the fucking TV working.
Joe, where can we check out this song? Play it.
You can head to Godwolf on Facebook. This song will be out this week.
Godwolf.
A big thank you to all our friends who've tuned in to watch it. It's been an absolute joy.
Can we
joy.
Get the fucking cart noise off, please?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to close out the show. Mark,
it's a fucking circus in here.
Shane... I just want to apologise for everything that's happened tonight. Shane is the producer
can
of the
we get Shane
show.
On here? Shane, come here.
Shane!
Come out here for a second.
Shane, someone needs
Shane.
To be
Shane, I've got Red Debbie! No, don't! It's her thing!
Oh, God.
It's not ours!
I'd just like to thank... What a success.
Don't okay. hurt Demi!
So... What a success. Ladies and gentlemen, Godwolf with this song.
Godwolf!
Go.
Shane!
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 Shane, get out of here, mate! Shane!
Can you feel my heart?
Shane!
Can
Shane,
you hear
your
me breathing? Can you feel my lungs with an air so secret?
Shane, I never told you this!
And this is just an interpretive dance.
Can you precious eyes?
I love you, Shane!
Called to be needed.
And Shane, I don't care.
And can
care
you treat my
love anyone says about our love
the way you want to be treated?
But Shane!
I'm just reading
you
the
are mine.
Oh, if this is the way
forever.
You want it,
If this is the way you see it going down, then I can't change it. You were the only one to fix it now, but don't erase it. I wouldn't trade our past for anything. Just try to face it and hear me answering.
I've got glass in my foot.
Happy Australia Day, you bunch of caramelized onions.
Well, that's good, Joe.
You can break my heart, but you can't stop it healing.
Please direct all complaints to Shane Dunlop.
Can you take my word?
Channel 31.
Yeah.
Because
against
the day,
what you're feeling,
he's the one who led us on. That's not
can
our
you
fault.
Stop and smile?
I'm not being held accountable. Shane Dunlop.
Fade with disaster.
That man right there.
Alright.
He's the one you gotta get.
Because ever since
three,
you.
I'm gonna be honest with you a little bit. I'm popping it in my mouth.
And there's been nothing Whee! After.
Whee! Shane! Get away,
if
Matt!
If this is the way you want it, if this is the way you see
sorry,
it
Shane.
Going down, then
I'm
I
sorry.
Can't change it. You were the only one to fix
Can
it now,
you to my
but don't
friend, Shane?
Erase it.
Come
I
here.
Wouldn't trade our past for anything. Just try to face it and
Come
hear
here,
me answering. If this is the way you want it,
Boys.
If this is the way you see it Let going it down, then I can't change it. You were the only one to fix
Broden.
It now, but don't erase it.
Mark.
I wouldn't trade our past for anything. Just try to face it and hear me answering. Fuck, I nearly got there.
Guys, can I join in?
Sure.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, happy Australia Day.
Oh!
Auntie
do
Donna.
Do? Just sort of jump in, take my pants off.
Woo! All right.
Oh!
Fuck
your
mug.
Oh. God, Australia.
Yet. You were the only one to fix
Can
it now,
but
don't
friend,
erase it.
Come
I
here.
Wouldn't trade our past.